Most people think time is like a river that flows swift and sure in one direction. But I have seen the face of time, and I can tell you, they are wrong. Time is an ocean in a storm. You may wonder who I am and why I say this. Sit down, and I will tell you a tale like none that you have ever heard. Know first that I am the son of Shahriman, a mighty king of Persia. On our way to Azad with a small company of men, we passed through India, where the promise of honor and glory tempted my father into a grievous error.
Now, my son.
Do you think I felt regret as I gazed upon the destruction we had wrought? Or at least humility at the speed with which a world can be transformed from a good world into a hell? If you think so, you are mistaken. For in that moment I thought of one thing only. The honor and glory I would bring my father by fighting like a warrior in my first battle. Many men that day sought to win honor and glory on the battlefield, that their king might say to them, as Khosrow said to Rustam, "You are the noblest of my warriors." From the moment my sword tasted blood, I knew this would not be my way. I would win my father's praise, not by killing, but by being the first to find the Maharaja's treasure vault and the wonders within. Wait. That's not how it happened. No, that's not...
Whoa! Shall I continue my story from here the next time we're interrupted? Done. I'll start the story from here next time.
Of time. There was a treasure I could carry with pride as a trophy of our victory. If I could only get there. The hourglass drew me, fascinated me. But to move it would take a dozen of my father's soldiers. I wanted a prize I could fit into one hand.
No, that didn't happen either. Wait. No.
It was time to get out. Now.
Father, I have brought us honor and glory.
Your Majesty, you promised me my choice of the Maharaja's treasures. That dagger!
Surely you won't deny the lad a souvenir of his first battle. You may have your choice of all the Maharaja's other treasures. Except that hourglass. That will make a fine gift for the Sultan of Azad when we pass through his city. And some exotic animals for his menagerie. And a few dozen slave girls. Yes, that should be enough.
I want no animals or maidens harmed until I have chosen. Let it be known, King Sharaman is merciful in victory.
Trust not a man who has betrayed his master, nor take him into your own service, lest he betray you too. I learned the truth of this, to my sorrow, the day that we arrived in Azad as the Sultan's honored guests.
My friend,
your visit brings joy and honor to my poor and humble dwelling. If only you'd given me time to prepare a proper welcome.
The glories of Azad are famed throughout the world.
They rose to fight again. I soon realized that only by taking into my own dagger the sands that possess them, I liberate them from their monstrous living death.
Thank you.
I'll stop the story from here next time.
You think me mad. I can see it by the look in your eyes. You think my story is impossible. Perhaps I am mad. Who would not be driven mad by... Horrors such as I have lived. But I assure you, every